Hello, and welcome to our video on analyzing data and drawing conclusions. The learning outcomes for this presentation are to identify the dependent and independent variables, the nature of the independent variable, the types of variables, the most appropriate statistical test, the statistical software to use, and how to interpret, discuss, and draw conclusions on the data. One of the most important parts of conducting a study is finding the cause and effect of something on something else, or a correlation between variables. It's important to determine what the cause is in your experiment and what the effect is. The variable that is being manipulated, or the cause, is the independent variable of your study. The variable that is being measured in your study, or the effect, is the dependent variables. You can have one population to multiple independent variables, and one or more dependent variables. An example of a study containing one dependent and one independent variable would be studying the effects of steroid use on sperm count. Here, we're testing the effects of steroid use on how it impacts the quantity of sperm. The steroid usage would be the independent variable, and the sperm count would be the dependent variable. It's important to determine the nature of the independent variable. The groups of the study can be two or more independent groups, or they can be dependent or matching groups. An example of an independent group is a study measuring the effects of a placebo drug versus an experimental drug on two separate groups of patients to see the effects of treating a disease. In this example, the two groups have two different groups of participants with different characteristics of each individual within each group. An example of a dependent group is a study measuring the effects of a placebo drug versus an experimental drug on the same group of patients, but in different time periods. In this example, the two groups that are being studied are the same exact people in each group, but at different time intervals. There are two main types of variables, which are categorical and continuous. Continuous variables are also known as normal data, or continuous data. Examples include age that is not categorized. For example, you could ask participants what their age is in years, or you could ask them which age group they fall into. Asking which age group they fall into is an example of categorical data. Categorical variables are those that have discrete categories or levels. Categorical data can be further described as nominal, ordinal, interval, or ratio. Nominal data is categorical but has no specific order. For example, colors, such as green, red, blue, they have discrete categories but are in no particular order. Ordinal data is categorical in nature but goes in order. For example, the categories small, medium, and large have a clear order in terms of their size. Interval data is categorical in nature and ordered as well, but has well-defined equal intervals. For example, if you were to choose age groups in 10-year intervals, you might group participants from 0 to 9 years, 10 to 19 years, 20 to 29 years, etc. Ratio data is categorical in nature, ordered, has well-defined intervals, but in addition includes the value 0. An example of ratio data would be age. As we could see in the previous example, you can be 0 years old if you're less than 1 year old. For ratio data, you need to have data that includes 0 and does not include negative values so that a ratio between two different variables can be calculated. Once you've determined the size of data you have, you can choose the most appropriate statistical test to analyze your data. That's why it's so very important to correctly identify the types of data you have and to identify which variables are dependent or independent. There are many websites that can give you reliable information here. Using a search engine, you can use the keywords statistical test to use chart to find a chart that is easiest for you to interpret. Once you've determined which statistical test is most appropriate, check to see if your data meets the assumptions of that statistical test. If the data does not meet the assumptions of the test and it is parametric, such as a t-test, then you may want to research the equivalent non-parametric statistical test, such as the Wilcoxon test. Once you've determined which statistical test you plan to use to analyze your data, you will run the test in either statistical software that you have access to or have purchased. PSPP and R have free public access. Excel is part of Microsoft Office, which is included as a student of Purdue Global University. SPSS and SAS are also good programs that can be purchased through the companies. Another way to run a statistical test is to use a search engine and input keywords in your search that contain the name of your statistical test, followed by the word calculator. For example, if you want to run an ANOVA, you can type into the search box of a search engine ANOVA calculator. The sites listed will ask for your data and then will give you a statistical output. Once you run the statistical analysis, the output your statistical software or online calculator may be confusing or foreign. This is where you should research the interpretation of the output and include the name of the software you used. For example, let's say you're given a p-value of 0.01, where you set the alpha value of 0.05. The interpretation of this output is that there is a statistically significant difference between the two groups being compared. Next, you'll take your interpretation and discuss the significance of that finding. You can also discuss how your results compared with others who conducted similar research. You can discuss what studies should be done in the future based on your findings, or a substudy that might branch off of this study. Lastly, you can write about the limitations of the study and any biases present that may have influenced your results. Lastly, the conclusion is a great place to give your reader a take-home message or messages. This is where you can leave the reader with what they should take away from the paper and summarizes succinctly your findings. In this seminar, we learned how to identify which variables of the study are dependent and independent, the nature of the independent variable, and the types of variables, such as continuous variables and categorical. After identifying the nature and types of variables, the most appropriate statistical test was identified and run through statistical software or a statistical online calculator. Lastly, we covered how to research, how to interpret the statistical output, discuss the results, and draw conclusions based on your analysis.